Miwahara Moto of Japan with the shovel serve starting off this quarter final encounter. Trying to pin the wide forehand of Chen Chenyi initially. This is tense already. Nice forehand flick.
Beautiful.
Chen Chenyi with the pendulum serves, the Viscaria blade. Miwahara Moto using her brother's butterfly signature blade. Maybe she'll get her own at this rate.
But indeed, it's so special, right, to be using your brother's blade.
Yeah, it's a good blade. I've used it myself. The acrylite carbon technology. I'm a bit of a geek with my table tennis catalogues, I must admit.
Yeah, and the carbon sheet helps you make the speed and the punch that comes in the ply.
7-ply, if I'm not mistaken, on these two blades. But enough about the equipment, more about the action. Miwahara Moto already in the lead. The first heartbreak. Great spin. Down the parallel, the hard side to play, isn't it? The short side, they call it. Short length, longer length, cross table.
Just back on one point on the equipment.
Yeah.
The woods or the ply that the players use become so special and precious to them because they keep trying many. And once they find their favorite one, they want to kind of stick to it to understand their style of play and understand how the wood will react to it.
Exactly. They like to wear in their blades a little bit more, but they don't with their rubbers. They'll change it probably after every match or a couple of matches. Comes right at the back of it. Too much so, Miwa. Chen now in the lead. 3 points in a row from the Chinese player. A hat trick. Close, to be fair. She had the bat high ready for the counter. Burns it on the line.
Well, that point showed why the Chinese is just a bigger and better player than Miwahara Moto, right? She was just sitting there ready for... Look at how easy it was to place that ball.
Yeah. She has got an effortlessness to her.
Yeah, I stand corrected. It's not easy, but it's just, it appears because she was right there and very effortlessly plays the ball.
Train hard so the match is easy. That's the philosophy. And it's the best one you can have.
And that was a nice change in pace from the Chinese.
Adds a bit of side to bend the ball wide, providing class. And it's not easy to get the ball past such a tall player who's got a bigger lateral swing. But the disadvantage of being a tall player, bigger crossover section, a bigger middle area the players will try and pin. She's leveled. The cadet. She's a cadet.
Mind-boggling for me. And I'm sure for all these, the audience who's sitting right here wondering what a 14-year-old can do.
Chen Chenyi, women's doubles bronze medalist in Houston. She's been a lot of the Japanese, Hirano, Kato, Nagasaki, and Hayata. Can she beat Miwa? The only one she's missing off the list there is Ishikawa.
The draw was actually that, but Miwa beat Ishikawa.
Exactly.
Earlier in the rounds.
That's a great point. That win she had against Ishikawa reminds me when Tomokazu, her big brother, beat Mitsutani at the 2017 World Championships in Dusseldorf. That was a bigger stage than this one, but different scenes. Pretty incomparable, really. Scene-wise, anyway, and on this scene, wise for her age. An old head on young shoulders. Miwa had it more, though. And we're saying that about a lot of these young players, Neha.
Yeah. It's nice to see that the younger generation has no fear, right? And the sort of game that they are playing is comparison to what the more experienced are. They're bridging the gap.
Such work. Oh, it comes back and it kind of bubbles. Miwa is going, what the? What happened to that ball? Let's see that again. What happened to the ball? Did you see that? It must have hit something on the table there. That was such an unnatural bounce. Maybe that should be a replay point. Oh, clutch from Miwa Haramoto. She did this against Chen Suyu as well. She saved game points when it was 10-8.
Beautiful strawberry receiving. And look at how wide those angles are. Very deceptive. I actually thought it was a cross court, but landed down the line.
The mental strength of Miwa Haramoto. And the sportswomanship to say, sorry. Game point now. Three in a row. Miwa Haramoto. Oh, it hits the finger. The forefinger is placed on her backhand side of the rubber.
Yeah, way too much side spin than what she actually thought.
Oh, that's great. Great through the wrist and the forearm from Chen Jinyi. To be relaxed there, it's a difficult shot to play.
A lot of work from the wrist.
One off the wrist, but she missed. Miwa Haramoto, you'd be unsurprised to see it save another game point in a way.
Yeah, the reaction says it all.
She's against serve though, the 14-year-old. And she serves another. A lukewarm serve from Chen Jinyi. Not great serve, to be fair. Maybe some nerves from the Chinese player. Because that serve, a lot of players, even outside the top 100, could have got that on. It wasn't great. Wasn't great. Miwa came over the top.
But good analytical mind from Miwa to react quickly on it.
Look at the work in the left. She nearly slipped there.
This 14-year-old is made of something else. Look at how deep she went to be able to give and impart that spin. And the cho says it all. Miwa Haramoto.
Coach Masakawa looking very philosophical in the corner. Oh, that was a better serve there, wasn't it, from Chen Jinyi. Half long.
Yeah, you have to give it to Chen Jinyi for that serve. A huge judgment error from Miwa.
More easily done though against the half long because it causes that indecision. Is it long enough to attack or too short? That one was long enough to attack, but it bent into the middle. Miwa using side spin into the middle there. Clever, clever, clever girl. A girl who's nearly in the semi-final of the women's in a star contender. And she wraps it up. Goodness, Neha, what a game. spraying the ball around in different positions, trying to go against the momentum of their opponent, both players. There you see Miwa playing the X's on the table. Cross court to cross court. Very hard to go down the line after your opponent's hit it cross court. Chen Chenyi is one of the best in the world at that, on both wings. Sheesh, kebab. Follow through from left leg to right leg, stable head, early timing point, low posture, wide leg base, had all the good mechanics of a cracking countertop spin from Chen Chenyi. Woman in blue on screen on the receive.
Bit of a poker phased Chen Chenyi, right? You see her just totally unfazed by whatever's happening in the match versus Miwa, much more animated, showing off her emotions.
Yeah, for sure. The Japanese women tend to be a lot more animated on the table than the Chinese women.
Look at those eyes.
She's losing her balance a little bit with the right leg. Does she have tape on the right wrist? I'm just trying to see it in a sec.
Look at the sweat that is on her forehead.
Hey, burns her out wide. She has to play the angle as well, because down this middle area, Chen Chenyi is pretty similar level, if not better than Miwa. Miwa knows she needs to get it wide early, and she did there. That was great angle, great angle. Right on the white paint.
Yeah, she broke no sweat to hit that for sure. Lovely long serve. You could see the Chinese was right in expecting a short one, but superb judgment from Miwa Harimoto at this point, and probably a very crucial juncture in the game. And another one! Two long pendulum serves from Miwa Harimoto. This is a game of mental toughness. This is a game of how well I can analyze my opponent and beat them right there at the start.
Can Miwa be the difference for the Japanese team? So many of the women have beaten the Chinese but then been worked out and struggled to do it again. Who's out there?
Mona Lisa Mehta, former India international. 6-4. Miwa Harimoto gradually maintaining her lead. And if she can do that, this will be a turn in destiny for Team Japan.
She's 14. Chen Chenyi is 23. This is what I keep saying. They don't have any 14-year-olds like Japan do, China. They don't. They seriously don't. Keep right on sword at Matsushima as well. They're going to let him lose soon, Team Japan.
Yeah, I think the Harimoto siblings are just a jewel for Japan, and they will preserve it well.
I love him. I love him. Doesn't need an introduction, but I'll give him one anyway. Ma Lin, the Olympic champion. The year you played at the Beijing Olympics, same year.
Yeah, and I saw that finals.
Ma Lin, the magician.
But here, trying to figure out the Japanese problem, Ma Lin. Miwa Harimoto, 14-year-old, totally shocking the entire Chinese community.
6-7. Chen Chenyi with the serve. Pendulum half long. Ah! And a good pickup.
Seems like she has answers to everything Chen Chenyi has to throw. And I wonder, Marlin, what is he thinking at this point? Is there a timeout that he can take? Is that needed? We'll see.
You will not be liking this, Marlin, at all. At all.
Nice recovery from Chen Chenyi. And I love that it's like they're inching one step closer, but then Miwa Harimoto takes the other point. So in all serves, both of them are winning 1 point each. We'll see who takes this one.
She's got the serve, Miwa. Reverse pendulum. What an angle. Oh my goodness me! She's 14, ladies and gentlemen. The same age that Tomokazu Harimoto, big brother, broke through. But she's paving her own way and writing her own destiny.
Miwa Harimoto is not fazed by the Chinese right in front of her. All she thinks of is the ball. How can I do it better? And I bet you all I'll show you what I'm made of. And fortune also favors the brave. Miwa Harimoto in lead, 10-7, up one game. Can she make it 2-0?
Speechless, speechless. The strawberry flick came out there. The angle she got with the backhand, then just a punch down the line. That was second to none.
10-8.
Tie break, third one of the game. Whoa. You can't take your eyes off this. Great angle from Chen Chenyi to save another.
Heartbreak for me. Big heartbreak. Take your time. Relax and then set in.
Be the highest level women's match we've witnessed here in Goa so far. That's why these two are up against each other now in this segment of the draw. Someone has to make it through to the final four. Saves another game point.
And we're back in deuce like it was in the last game. Harimoto had steeled it 15-13. And here in the second one, it's 11-11.
What a transition. Again, going cross court to cross court.
And what speed and reactions from Harimoto there. Just no time for the opponent to think, react, move at all. And she's done it. She takes the second game, 13-11.
Third game.
She lost to Zhang Rui in the contender final that she reached last season. And now she's facing a similar ranked opponent and is one away from winning. An improvement in only a few months. And it's recognisable some aspects. But in other ways, mentally especially, she seems like a completely different player, Miwa Harimoto. Ooh, nearly feels it back. Nearly.
Yeah, and a great effort by Miwa to actually react and try to get the ball back.
This is against a player that's won 3 WTT titles in Chen Chenye.
And that's a shaky start from Miwa. Chen Chenye maintaining her calm and composure.
Can't afford to think about the finish line for 1 second. That's what I will say. To come back is possible. Really is possible.
One, four.
Tactically, what do you think Chen Chenye needs to continue to do in this game to take this to a fourth now?
Keep pinning it deep to the backhand side, because forehand is the one where Miwa has been stronger in finishing off the rallies.
White.
So if she can stop her from that, probably be beneficial. And she takes the early lead, and a lead of 4 points, 5-1. It's pretty hard at this point for Miwa to actually recover from this.
A momentum switch. She's just giving away a little bit more cheap. The world number 41, 14-year-old. Chen Chenye's recovery, we know he's incredible. Oh, she can play the lines, even when under pressure, from a cross-court ball. The tall left-hander, 6-1 up, looking likely to send this to a fourth at least.
It's like both of them playing mind games. There was a lovely push deep on the body of Chen Chenye. Right off the bounce. Too quick, too swift.
Taking a bit more time between serves as well, which is a good tactic, just delaying matters. Making Miwa Haramoto impatient. Chen Chenye obviously Haramoto with the last serve in this one.
Love the way she continues to fight. The long lead is really not a deterrent for Miwa Haramoto.
Chen Chenye is young, but Miwa Haramoto is nearly a decade younger. A decade. That's a completely different generation. That's over 2 Olympics different. And how many world championships? 5.
That's great perspective, Fraser. Just goes to show that what this 14-year-old can achieve in the future. However, Chen Chenye here, very solid, very stable. 6-point lead in the third game.
She's got less holes in the game already than Mimi Ito. I can see that clearly. The way she's playing here, she should be playing Paris 2024 singles alongside Hayata. Seriously. If she continues this rate of improvement in 12 months, she'll be top 10 and she'll be in the conversation.
10-4.
Surely she can't deny Chen Chenye this game. Then you'd really start to ask questions of Chen Chenye's ability mentally to get over the line. Physical, there's no question, she's brilliant. But mentally, she could be 2-0 up now.
The heat is burning.
The candle getting lower and lower. Burning it at both ends, Chen Chenye. strawberry push.
So brave. So brave. It's almost like she's so sure of this, and she's practiced this so much in practice, the strawberry, to attempt it at 10-6.
Kicking like a mule.
Wow, 4 points in a row for Miwa Harimoto from 10-4 to 10-8. Can she level this to 10-10? We'll see.
So a comeback from 9-2 down from Cheng Yiqing against Samara, the former European champion. This would arguably be, well, just as good.
And the timeouts for both have been exhausted.
Well, finally, Chen Chen Yi is able to do it. But Miwa still, I'd say, with the more momentum. Fascinating match, especially now. We're going to have to see Miwa Harimoto bring out another gear if she can.
Yeah, this one reminds me actually of the FIFA World Cup Finals a couple of months back. What a turn it was, similar to maybe what the Chinese is here trying to attempt.
In the last brink of the game before full time, coming back. Send it to a leveler.
1-2.
You know, Miwa. I want to know what is and how is Miwa outside of the table. Is she cute? Is she chirpy? You know, is she yet another girl? Or is she the fighter, the serious one, which is she on court? And that is what I love about sport, right? The different sort of personalities that players depict on and off the court is just so amazing to see.
She earned herself the nickname the Dancing Queen, and I'll tell you why in a second. It was a pretty viral moment where one of the WTT social media staff captured her dancing in preparation for a match with her headphones on.
Yes, I remember that.
So she's definitely a free spirit off the table.
Yeah, and you can surely see the free-spirited Miwa Harimoto leading 2-1.
Who's the momentum with now, Neha?
Surely with the Chinese, right? You can see her much more stable, less unforced error, and actually forcing Miwa to make those errors. Right now, she's like a wall. Chen Chen Yi?
Doesn't seem to be as big of a factor, momentum against Miwa. She's so good at saving game points. Unreal. She's an example of a young player already who understands the fine line between reacting too soon and reacting too late. She treats each point on its own merit, no matter the score. And in such a tight, fast and furious best of five format, that is very effective. And will continue to be so in this new WTT product.
Yeah, I love that, Fraser, how you put it, that she treats every ball on its merit. And that's what you have to do, right? And it's hard because you have to stay in the present. You cannot be thinking about the past or the future. Just right there, what the ball deserves.
Whoa, the forehand slap. Right, Master Shifu. You go to him to improve. You've got an all knowing third eye of the sport, a wisdom that transcends beyond generations within table tennis, and now passing down his knowledge to the new generation of the China women's team. And this is the reason why the China women's team is even further ahead in the game than the China men's team, because the men's ex-Olympic champions are now coaching the women's team. And that's why they're playing more like the men now, the Chinese women. They're more physical, more aggressive. Oh wow, nothing to add there. That was great commentary.
Thank you.
Genuine as well. I can see you just beaming with happiness at the prospect here. Look how much she wants it in those eyes. Goodness me, it looks good. Kill
7-6.
Shadow playing, acknowledging where she went wrong, willing to try and fix it. 7-6 to Chen Chenyi, who's done brilliantly to stay in this match and in the lead.
And she fights it back. She is not gonna rest until she gets it, Miwa.
Well, she'll be thinking, if I can save 5 or 6 game points, I can come back from 1 point down. And Chen Chenyi knows that too, as she looks over to Ma Lin with a look of concern, big look of concern. Kick a serve into middle.
And this is really thrilling here, Fraser. Look at that, what a superb recovery. And Miwa Harimoto now has the lead. She's leading 2-1 and now 8-7.
You'd be an idiot to rule her out of a comeback. Look what she's doing here. Down the line.
So deceptive. She's not done that at all in the game as far as I can recall. And so brave to attempt it for the first time at this stage of this quarterfinal match.
Oh, in two minds. Chen Chenyi equally in a... Well, definitely the last two games has just not given in. Never given up. Chen Chenyi serving 8-9. Perfect timing. She's got 2 match points. Can she join her brother's success? Getting into the final 4 of singles.
Well, Miwa Harimoto wears her heart on her sleeve, reacts to the ball, what it merits, and look what she has done.
She's beaten Liu Weishan. Can she add Chen Chenyi to the list of Chinese wins? She can! Miwa Harimoto sails into the semis! Is there